Welcome back all of you to our online platform, that is our school's YouTube channel. So again we are ready with today's video. This video is for class 6 and the subject is maths, and we are continuing, or we are supposed to start which we have discussed yesterday. We have to start the new chapter, that is chapter number 7, and the name of the chapter is fractions. By mistake yesterday we have written that chapter number 6, so correctly this is chapter number 7 and the name of the chapter is fractions. So yesterday we have discussed some terms, means the definition of fractions, types of fractions, improper fraction, proper fraction, like fraction, unlike fraction, mixed fraction. So at the same time we have also discussed question number 1 and question number 2 of this exercise 7.1. today we will discuss the remaining questions of this exercise. In question number 3, some parts are given like that. First one, I will discuss the first one only. That question number 3, one triangle is there in which this is like that, and the this part had been shaded and it is written 1/2. Whether it is 1/2 or not, if not, why? So this is not 1/2, because in the fractions all the parts should be equal. Here this part and this part both are not equal. This is larger than this one, that's why this does not represent 1/2. To represent like this, we are supposed to, if the triangle is like that and if you are doing like this, so like this we have divided this triangle into 4 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. If we want to represent half, then we will represent 2 parts, this one and this one. Now this is 2 out of 4, means 1/2. This is not 1/2. So similarly in the next one, rectangle is there, all the parts are not equal. You can see in circle also all 4 parts are not equal. To display the circle, we should divide the circle into 4 parts like this, not like this. We cannot divide like this. This is wrong, this is right. All the parts should be equal. So like this we are supposed to complete that question. That is question number 3 of exercise 7.1. after that we will move forward to question number 4. What fraction of a day is 8 hours?
What fraction of a day is 8 hours?
So how many hours are there in one day? In one day, as
1 day is equal to 24 hours.
So we have to represent the fraction of a day. What fraction of a day is 8 hours? Means that will be 8 hours and total hours are 24. So 8 upon 24 is the answer of this question. The quantity upon total quantity. Kiska hame ratio nikalna hai? That is on the upper side, and the total quantity on the lower side. How many hours are there in one day? That is 24. And how many we are considering here? 8 hours. 8 hours out of 24, means 8 upon 24 is the answer of this question. At the same time, question number 5. What is given in question number 5? What fraction of an hour is 40 minutes. We have to find the ratio of 40 minutes to 1 hour. Means the answer will be like that, 40 minutes to 1 hour, but this is minutes. So both the quantity should be in the same units. So 40 in 1 hour, we know how many minutes are there, 60. So 40 upon 60 is the answer for question number 5th. Now question number 6, Arya, Abhimanyu and Vivek shared lunch. Arya has bought 2 sandwiches, one made of vegetables and one of jam. The other 2 boys forgot to bring their lunch. Arya agreed to share his sandwiches so that each person will have an equal share of each sandwich. The first part is there. How can Arya divide his sandwiches to so that each person has an equal share? So how Arya can divide? There are three boys are there. So he will divide each sandwich into 3 parts which are equal. So each will have one part from the sandwich of vegetable and one part from the sandwich of jam. So what part of a sandwich will each boy receive? Total parts are 3. How many parts one will receive? 1. So what will be the fraction? 1 upon 3. So 1 upon 3 is the answer of B. And how to divide the sandwich, that is the answer for part A. Means each sandwich has to be divided into 3 equal parts. So question number 7. Kanchan dyes dresses. C had to dye 30 dresses. C has so far finished 20 dresses. What fraction of dresses has C finished? So we have to do that question. That is question number 7. Total number of dresses that is 30. Dresses already finished means dyed, means dresses finished 20. Fraction of dresses finished. अब question क्या है? Means what is the name of that? The Kanchan. Kanchan has to dye the dresses. Dye means to color the dresses. How many dresses are there? 30. He has already dyed 20 dresses. So what is the fraction of the dresses already dyed? Means जितको color हमने कर दिया है. So what will be the answer here? Number of dresses finished dyeing upon total number of dresses. So how many dresses she has already finished dyeing, that is 20, and total number of dresses is 30. So the fraction is 20 upon 30. So like this you are supposed to proceed. Now question number 8. Question number 8 and 9 are the important questions. So question number 8, as I am rubbing the board at the same time, you can read that question number 8. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8, राइट द नेचुरल नंबर्स फ्रॉम 2 to 12. नेचुरल नंबर्स फ्रॉम 2 to 12 मीन्स 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now, these are natural numbers from 2 to 12. What fraction of them are prime numbers? Prime numbers. Now, as we have discussed already, the prime numbers are those numbers which are having exactly two factors. Or in other words, or in simple language, we can say that the prime numbers are those numbers which are divisible by themselves only. वो अपनी खुद की टेबल में ही आते हैं, किसी दूसरी टेबल में नहीं आते हैं. So first of all, we are supposed to mark the prime numbers. How many prime numbers are there? 2 is a prime number, 3 is a prime number, 5 is a prime number, 7 is a prime number. After 7, 11 is a prime number. So prime numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Number of primes is equals to 5. Total numbers one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11. Total numbers are 11. So we have to find the fraction of the prime numbers. Fraction of primes will be equals to number of primes upon total numbers, and that is number of primes is 5 and total numbers are 11. So in the simple language, we can say 5 numbers out of these 11 are prime numbers. That is simple. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers are there which are prime, and total numbers are there 11. At the same time, the next question is there, question number 9. Question number 9, write the natural numbers from 102 to 113. What fraction of them are prime number? That is the same. First of all, you are supposed to write the prime numbers from 102 to 113. Then you are supposed to select the prime numbers. After that, you are supposed to find the fraction of the prime numbers. In question number 10, what fraction of these circles have x in them? So total number of circles are 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, and x are having 4. So the fraction will be 4 upon 8. At the same time, question number 11, Christian received a CD player for her birthday. She bought 3 CDs and received 5 other as a gift. She bought 3 and got 5 CDs as a gift. So total number of CDs is 8. What fraction of her total CDs she buy? How many she buy? 3. Total is 8. So 3 by 8 is the fraction of the CD she bought. And the second one, what fraction did she receive as a gift? How many CDs she received? 5. And total 8. So 5 upon 8 is the fraction which she received as a gift. So like this, you are supposed to proceed the questions of this exercise. I hope that you have understood, and you will try to solve the questions of this exercise. After completing the questions, you are supposed to take the pic of that, and you are supposed to upload on the school's WhatsApp number. If you are facing any kind of problem, or if you are having any kind of doubt, then you can message us, or you can even call us. We will try to rectify your doubts so that you can easily proceed the questions given in your textbook. Thank you. Thank you very much.